Hello everyone. Today I have a very special guest among us, Miss Neha Chiller, who have cracked this exam in her first attempt and scored 99.85 percentile. So I congratulate her and welcome her to this interview. Hello, Neha. How are you?
Hello, ma'am. Thank you so much for having me.
So, Neha, let's start with this interview. And my first question to you would be, what are your qualifications before clearing this exam?
Okay, so I did BCom honors from Dolatram College, University of Delhi. Then I got admission in Delhi School of Economics for MCom. And right now I am in my second year of MCom. See, after completion of my first year, I became eligible for this exam. So I just gave this 2020 June attempt.
Great. So since this was your first attempt, for how long have you been practicing for this particular exam?
Initially, I started the preparation in March, just after filling the application form. But those were the initial days of pandemic. The scenario was totally uncertain, so I was not able to continue with my preparation.
Mm-hmm.
So technically, I started my preparation in August only,
mm-hmm.
and the exam was in October. So my preparation lasted for 2 months around.
Right. So you cracked this exam in just 2 months. I must ask you, what were the study material that you referred to? What were the books that you referred to? Because you were very quick with this preparation.
So for paper one, I referred KVS Madan. This book has good conceptual clarity. And I also referred past year papers for paper one. I did 3-4 years past year papers.
Mm-hmm.
And as far as paper two is concerned, I did not find any one particular book which had covered all the syllabus. So I referred to my graduation and post-graduation notes and books that helped a lot in conceptual clarity. Apart from that, I referred Truman's book for practice questions. It has good number of MCQs. And thirdly, I did past year papers for paper two as well from 2016 to 19.
That is really nice. I'm sure a lot of people will learn from that and will start their preparation like that only. So the next question would be, what was your strategy? Because you are an MCom student, you must have some assignments related to your master's work as well. What was the strategy and what was the routine that you followed to crack this exam?
Okay, so I used to get around 2 to 3 hours daily for this preparation. And on Sundays or off days, I used to get 5 to 6 hours. So what I did was I divided this time in two equal parts. In first part, I used to do whatever unit I was doing, like the conceptual work. And in second part, I used to do the practice questions. So I used to give equal time for practicing questions right from the day one. And that helped me a lot.
Mm-hmm.
Secondly, what I divided the whole preparation in three phases. In first phase, I did those units over which I had some stronghold, like international business, business finance. These were my strong areas. So first, I choose these units and they take around 1-1.5 weeks for completion. Then in phase two, I choose those units which I had some idea, but I had studied them a long time back. Like we had HRM, which was in second year of graduation. So I did such units in this second phase, and such units took around 3 to 4 weeks. So overall, after the completion of phase one and phase two, I was done with more than 50% of my syllabus within 1 month.
Mm-hmm.
So whatever time I was left with, I did my weak points, like I was somewhat weak in legal aspects of business or business statistics. So I chose these topics in last phase.
Mm-hmm.
This was my strategy.
So if I may summarize your strategy, so you concentrated on your strong parts first, because you know this exam is very repetitive. You have to revise a lot to take the exam. So you first concentrated on those. And since you cannot leave any part of syllabus, you concentrated on your weak points as well.
Definitely.
Okay, great. I'm sure like that is a great advice, and people will like follow. If they are following this, they will be they would crack this exam, and at the end of the day, they would have a very clear conceptual clarity too.
Yes, different people have different strong points, so they need to identify them and then work accordingly.
So how did you identify those? Did you take some mock tests and if we are talking about mock tests, how many mock tests did you take? How many past year did you solve before taking this exam?
Oh, yes, definitely past year papers helped a lot. If you do past year papers, then they help in first identifying your strengths, your core areas, your weaknesses, the areas where you need to work more.
Mm-hmm.
Secondly, by doing past year papers, you can identify the trend or the pattern in which questions are asked over the years, and the topics which carry more weightage, like they are bound to come in every exam.
Mm-hmm.
Like there is a topic of international trade theory. Question will always come from this concept. Then there is capital budgeting techniques, deductions under Section 80 of income tax.
Mm-hmm.
So these are the topics you cannot afford to miss.
Right.
So you need to identify such topics by doing past year papers. And as far as mock tests are concerned, they are also equally useful. They help in time management. So see, if exam you know the answers but you lack of time, then it's of no use.
Mm-hmm.
So mock tests prevent you from such situation. I personally did not face any difficulty in time management, so I did not opt for the mock test, but I did practice questions.
Right.
I did a lot of like thousands of practice questions. I used to do practice questions from the day one. 50 to 100 questions I used to do daily.
Mm-hmm. Right, right. So you have to practice a lot to crack this exam. Right. So the next question would be, what are the difficulties that you faced during this exam? Since we were in a global pandemic, there must have been some difficulties. Also, you were preparing for your MCOM assignments. What were those difficulties and how did you cope up with them?
See, when I started my preparation in the same month, our third semester classes also started. So we used to have classes from 9 a.m. in the morning to 5 p.m. in the evening. So yeah. I hardly go 2 to 3 hours daily for this preparation.
Mm-hmm.
So to compensate that, I used to study more on Sundays or whatever holidays we got. So I used to devote at least 5 to 6 hours on off days. That's how I managed. So time constant, I would say, was a major difficulty for me.
Mm-hmm. Right. So you cope up with that, like with consistency and by practicing a lot of questions. And that's how you crack this exam.
Yes, definitely.
So enough about the discussion on this exam. Let's talk about you now. So what are your future plans? Are you going for some PhD research or you are looking for some teaching job after your MCOM?
See, I'm very much passionate about teaching. I love teaching. So I'm planning to go for assistant professor first. And in future, if need arises, then I'll go for research at a later stage.
All right. So all the very best for that. I'm sure you are going to get whatever you wish for, and all the very best for that.
Thank you so much.
So the last question would be, what is the advice that you would like to pass on to our students who are still preparing for this exam?
Okay, so I will give three advices. The first one is, please understand the importance of practice questions. They help you a lot. So please do a lot of practice questions. Second advice would be consistent throughout your preparation. It is not an exam which can be cracked by studying for 1 or 2 days before the paper or by relying totally on the guesswork. You need to work hard, and that too with some consistency. So be consistent. And the third advice would be, see, there is no ideal strategy which fits for all the aspirants. So you yourself have to introspect and identify what are your strengths, your capabilities, and the approach which suits you. So work on that.
Mm-hmm.
And lastly, I would like to put one of my favorite quotes. It says that I find that the harder I work, the more luck I seem to have.
Right.
If you work hard, luck will be with you. Mm-hmm. Believe in yourself and you will be able to make it.
That is a great advice and a great mantra. I'm sure whoever is listening to us will be inspired by your story and your strategy. Thank you for taking this interview, Neha. Thank you for making time for us.
Thank you. Thank you so much for having me.
Thank you and have a nice day.
Thank you.